Hi guys, welcome to my program. Today we are going to talk a powerful word. It's called Word of God. When you hear Word of God, what comes in your mind? What do you think is that? I am Desire Rubasha. I'm your preacher. I preach by experience and my knowledge. And every time we share some things we heard many times, but we did pay attention on those little things we talk every day. When I used to hear the word of God, I used to think it's just a word come from God somewhere in heaven, or if you go to Bible study, somebody had to read the Bible verses, say, that is word of God. But I realized, no. The word of God is so powerful. I tell you, by a natural believer teaching you, you are God. Your mind is your God. So today you have to know the word of God is the come from you. Everything you tell somebody, it's God. You are God. And also remember, you have somebody you talk to every day. Your mind always is going to tell you a word. Your mind always communicate with you. Never again think the word is something outside of you. No, the word is with you. The word we are talking here, it's a word which is you. It's your God lives you. And I could see the translation of a word here say, scripture speak of the word of God. The meaning is that thing God has said. See, thing God has said. Which is God? Which God is one? It's you. Everything you say, it's you because you are God. But scripture also say the phrase, the word of God as a name. As a name of Jesus Christ. Just listen to the way John Gospel began. See, that's how now the word again, it become a person. And the person, it's in you, your imagination, your mind. Because when you talk to your mind, inside you, no one sees it. It's like you're talking to somebody else. You've never been alone. That is another secret I'm telling you. You will never be alone. Always you are going with somebody. And that somebody is powerful. It's your God who lives with you. Everywhere you are walking, everywhere you go, that person is with you. And that I'll say, John 1 say, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. See, that how to say, Word, it's you. We used to think different way to think God, the word of God is somebody outside of you. No. And when now you go to know, every word come from you. If come from God, that means it's powerful. Everything you tell somebody is powerful. The way it's so powerful word is most powerful things you have ever seen. Because again, he has the power of God, the power of everything. Because the word kills you and the word saves you. When you talk about kills you, not killing to die, but somebody you love is going to tell you a word in the morning. Your wife, your children, your loved one, and that word, he can mess your day the whole day because somebody's word or somebody's statement. And that's how the word kills you. Kills your mood. Make your day miserable because somebody tells you the word. And then also the word saves you. Somebody can tell you a good word. That word gospel, a good news, and which is going to make your day again be nice, be pleasant. So now I'm teaching you this way to know every word you're telling somebody is a powerful. It's so powerful. It kills somebody or it saves somebody. So now, what are we going to choose to tell somebody? It's within you. How are you going to live with your loved one? Which word do you want to keep telling them? There are people who are strong, who keep bringing their word as a sword. They keep telling people the word which hurts them. There are people who keep not communicating to your mind first. What are you going to tell these people? Is it good for them? Is it going to kill them? Or is it going to save them? And that is powerful. And if you say something nice to somebody, or if somebody has said something to you, how do you feel inside yourself? Somebody tell you something's a good word, you get something, it could be anything, you get gold, you get a work, congratulations, or something you have done, you hear a good word, your day becomes much better. Again, you hear a bad word, and then your day becomes miserable. But as we say, life, it has to have both. Life is to experience the good of evil. So now, how also you going to deal with the bad word you hear from somebody? How you going to let that word affect you? So that is so key, because always our mind, it's our God. Everything you get, a good or bad, it's you how you take it. You got to know the word come from somebody. If the word will kill you, it's you yourself who are going to protect yourself. It's you who have got to know, no, I'm going to. Can I allow this word distract me? Can I allow this word mess my day? That is the key. And the way you do it, through your mind. You talk with your mind, you deal with every word. Don't allow that word kills you. That's the most times you have been killed by somebody's word, somebody's thought, somebody's opinion. So now you got to learn to be stronger, powerful, to deal with that, to know. Is it somebody's idea? Is it somebody's thought? You could be able to protect yourself. Our mind is the only way it's going to protect you. Because the mind which is killed is the mind which is saved. That is how it works. Everything is within us. That's the thing you're going to experience. The good and evil always is with you, around you. And always is there. Around you, from your family, from your relative, from your friends. Everything's that we go to learn. So that I'll say, my teaching is going to tell you, as in the family, as you're talking with your loved ones, as you are talking with your friends, this is how we go to learn to protect other people's mind, to learn to understand it. And only way to understand it is when you know how powerful your word it is. And that times you could be able to live in peace to tell everyone the word they want to hear. But sometimes they say, oh, is the truth? You have to tell the truth. Or the truth can set you free, or the truth can kill you. And all is just come through the mind. It's just come through working with your God. To know you, what you're going to tell this person. And that is so powerful. And that is why you go to found the way you learn, the way we think to say, okay, I need peace with people. I need peace with my family. I need peace with my friends. I need peace for my worker, co-workers. It starts from in your mind. It starts within you. Yes. Everything starts within you. To be happy, to be unhappy, the power is within you. To make other people, that is not your business. Other people, they go to look after themselves. That is how the power of God it is. You look after yourself, be happy for yourself, the happy will come to you. We have been struggling to make other people happy, which is so hard. But to tell them the good word, it's help. It's help for themselves to choose how they go to take it. It's not a good word you tell somebody, you take it nicely or to be able to save. That is the powerful. So the powerful is going to be how are you going to take the word of God. And that is why these are the things we see every day, but we don't pay attention for it. Pay attention for your word. You are powerful. And that is why I'm here, to inspire, to motivate each other. Is this experience we continue to share in my program. This natural belief, to believe everything is dealing with us, to believe as we are responsible for everything we do. We will continue to sharing this, and always, that's how we go. I keep asking your support and to subscribe to my YouTube channel at Ndizeye Rubasha. And subscribe, you keep updated to the new episode. And thank you. Have a nice day.